बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलामुअलैकुम। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस एंड स्टार्ट अनदर टॉपिक दैट इज़ टेकन फ्रॉम चैप्टर नंबर 4, हिस्ट्री ऑफ पाकिस्तान, एंड टॉपिक नेम इज़ ऑब्जेक्टिव रेजोल्यूशन 1949। फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस इट्स ब्रीफ बैकग्राउंड इंट्रोडक्शन, एंड देन आई विल गो टूवर्ड्स द इट्स मेन पॉइंट्स एंड देन इट्स इम्पॉर्टेंस। सो फर्स्ट आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस इट्स बैकग्राउंड। You know that objective resolution has got the status of fundamental document in the constitution making history of Pakistan. This resolution was passed by the Prime Minister Liaquat Ali Khan from the Constituent Assembly on 12th March 1949. The resolution laid down the guiding principles on the basis of which the upcoming constitution of Pakistan was to be formed. So the resolution was passed by the assembly with heavy majority. Actually, objective resolution main objective was to prepare a sketch and draft for the upcoming constitution. So now come towards the main points of the objective resolution. Following were its main points. The first main point of the objective resolution was that sovereignty over all the universe belongs to Allah Almighty, and the people of Pakistan will exercise these powers within the prescribed limits as a sacred trust. The second important point was that the power of the state will be exercised through the elected representative of the people. Third point was the Islamic principles of democracy, freedom, tolerance, and social justice will be fully observed. Another important point of the objective resolution was the Muslims of Pakistan will be enabled to order their lives according to the teachings of Islam. Another important point of objective resolution was that minorities will be given due freedom to lead their lives according to their religion and culture. You know very well that what is the status of minorities in our country Pakistan. Although they are less in number, but equal rights are given to them, then all the fundamental human rights will be guaranteed. All the fundamental human rights means the right to speak, right to write, right to make property, right to adopt any kind of culture, and right to get education, etc. All these are fundamental rights. So under objective resolution, all the fundamental human rights were secured. Then another point was independence of judiciary shall be fully secured. You know that judiciary is one of the important organ of the government. Government is made up of three main organs. One is executive, the second one is the legislature, and the third one is judiciary. So what is the function of judiciary? To provide safety and to provide justice to the people. So under objective resolution, it was also declared that independence will be given to the courts or to the judiciary. What kind of independence means? All the courts, all the judiciary will be independent in their decision making. Okay, then another important point of the objective resolution was the federal system of government will be established in the country, in which provinces will be given autonomy with such limitations as may be prescribed. Federal form of government was and is there in our present constitution. And federal form of government means that kind of government where all the rules and regulations of the constitution that are written in the constitution will be applied in the whole country, in each and every part of the country. Like in our country Pakistan, there are four provinces. There is capital Islamabad, then there are tribal areas, so no part will be left behind, and everyone will be must have to follow all these rules and regulation. Everyone will obey all these rules and regulation, and each and every part of the country will be under the jurisdiction of that constitution. Another definition in the federal form of government is that different powers like defense, currency, trade, communication, etc., all these powers will be equally divided among the center and the provinces. That is another meaning of the federal form of government. So separate list of powers will be divided among the center and the provinces. Okay, so federal system of government will be established in the country in which provinces shall be given autonomy or power with such limitations as may be prescribed. So these were the main points of the objective resolution. Now come to the importance. The first importance of the objective resolution was that, and you can see in all these main points, that Islamic ideology was given more importance. Most of the points are related to Islam. So when this resolution was drafted or prepared, and when it was passed, it was taken into account that all the Islamic principles will be observed and Islamic ideology will be safeguarded, not only in the objective resolution but in all the coming constitution. Then another importance of the objective resolution, that it provided a base for all the successive constitution. As the main purpose of the objective resolution was to make a constitution, was to provide it a sketch or to draft for to prepare the constitution, because since 1947 up till 1949 the work was going on, but due to the differences of the different leaders or people of the assembly, up till now the framing of the constitution was incomplete. So that's why the main purpose was to provide a draft or pattern or sketch to make a future constitution. So when objective resolution was passed, then it became a base for all the successive constitution, because on the basis of objective resolution all the constitutions were framed. Then another importance of objective resolution is that it was adopted as a preamble. Preamble mean an introductory part of the constitution. It means that as the first constitution in force in 1956, at that time in the constitution the objective resolution was the introductory part. Okay, so another importance of the objective resolution is that it became a part of 1973 constitution, basic part of 1973 constitution. Because as I said that before 1973 it was adopted as a preamble. Objective resolution was adopted as a preamble in the 1956 and in 1962 constitution. But later on, when the third constitution came in 1973, which is also our present constitution, then in 1985 an amendment was made. And through that amendment, which was done in 1985, then objective resolution was not only a preamble, but it also became one of the basic part of our present 1973 constitution. So that is the importance of objective resolution. Thank you very much.